So in this video, I want to show you just how to load a CSV file. So I'm going to say escape M enter return. Let's say loading.csv file. And right at the beginning, just two pound signs, make it a heading 2, loading a CSV file. Now, very important that the notebook that I'm using here and the CSV file, the comma separated values, spreadsheet files, they are in the same folder. If they were not, I would have to refer to the whole address of that file on my hard drive. So I'm going to say DB, that is going to be my computer variable that is going to hold this table, and I'm going to use the load table function, load table. And in inverted commas, in quotation marks, I'm going to say data.csv. That is the name of my CSV file. Let's have a look at it. And there you see it's a table with 200 rows and 9 columns. Again, just as before, this is now a table object. And let's just go for some descriptive statistics. Let's go for that on the HR column. And we're going to group by the histo column. Let's try that. So I'm going to say group by, and let's group by, let's make a list here. I'm going to say the mean, the median, the standard deviation, the variance, and let's go for the quantiles. Quantile, there we go. And what object do I want? The DB object. The computer variable, I want it to be grouped by the histo column, whatever the unique values are in that categorical variable. And my selection is what I want all of these descriptive statistics to be done on is in the HR column. There we go. We see in histo it found two entries, a 0 and a 1. And we see for HR in 0 and for HR in 1, we see all these descriptive statistics beautifully done. Let's try one of the filter commands. Remember how that works? Filter function. So I'm going to filter, and let's create our anonymous function. Again, just using P, you can use whatever you want, P. And I want that to be in the histo column. And I want to say when that equals 0. So again, it's a Boolean question. It's going to return all the true values. And please look in the DB object. And if we filter, and if we look down, if we do look down the histo column, we'll see that it's all just the zeros. It'll only select the zeros that are in there. So that is how you import a CSV file. Keep it to a CSV file. If you're working in a spreadsheet, save it as a DOS, a disk operating system, a CSV file. And you can just import it with a load table. It'll do automatically look for column headers in the first row that you have. And then it is just a table object, and you can work on it as we have done before.